This is video number 530. How to surrender all to God. Let it find you. This is my new favorite concept of knowing how God approves of something in my life. I have a new motto. Lord, please can I have this, but let it find me. I do not want to go looking for it. It all started with my absolute new obsession and hunger to read all Paulo Coelho's books. But since all of his books are spiritual conquests, I want my library also to be spiritual conquests. I have decided not to go into a new bookstore. Instead, I pop into every second-hand bookstore that I see and I ask my favorite question, do you have any Paulo Coelho books? I have since read only The Alchemist, his most popular book. Then I slowly savour Warrior of the Light. This is a collection of short wisdom nuggets. It almost reminds me of Proverbs in the Bible. Last week I had a date with Aleph, and what a magical date it was. I found the book at Mia's bookstore in my favorite street in Pretoria. It is in Queenswood and the street is named after South Africa's Picasso. The street is named Pierneef Street, and the name already hints at the beauty in the street. When it is October and the Brazilian jacaranda trees are full blossom, it is like you are stepping into a fairy tale. It is so beautiful. The street constantly reminds me of one of my favorite verses in the book of Jude. To him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you before his glorious presence without fault and with great joy. It is only appropriate that an elation that I found my Brazilian author in a street that is beautifully decorated by Brazilian flora. I struck up a fantastic, thought-provoking conversation about the toxicity of social media indulgence with the owner in old books, Mia, and it was already divine, having a philosophical debate with this bright, profound girl. I love days like this, when Taylor Swift's song is slowly playing in my soul. Today is a fairy tale. Sometimes fairy tales are in the form of a romantic hot date. Other days, it's in the form of finding things in a serendipity manner.
Today was a fairy tale, you were the prince. I used to be a damsel in distress. You took me by the hand and you picked me up at six. Today was a fairy tale.
The story about Abraham's wife that interfered with the destiny of having a baby and then outsourcing her destiny to the Egyptian princess slave Hagar, still to today have such a detrimental effect. I do not want to have any more Hagars in my life. I want Isaacs in my life, the child of laughter, the source of joy, finding Paulo Coelho the organic way. I have since started with my Paulo Coelho organic quest, surrendered so many other facets into this category. Please, Lord, I pray, let it find me, the same way the books find me. Another Let It Find You story. At Bet-Seber, the House of Hope for Women, we outsource all the hospitality duties to a guest house so that we as the Bet-Seber team can only focus on the emotional needs of our dearest princess guests God has entrusted to us. I recently realized that our current guest house has changed strategies and it made our life difficult to accommodate both our needs and the needs of our other guests. Not using the guest house as an emotional retreat. I prayed about it. God, should I go and look for a different guest house? A couple of days later, I got a phone call from the guest house, from the best guest house in our area. They have a 4-star rating and they contacted us. They offer their services at a reduced rate. I was ecstatic. May God to teach you how to surrender all to Him, your request, your deepest heart's desires, even if it is too with a treasure hunt of finding your favorite author's books.